Good evening, everyone. For today's video, we will be discussing about the difference between a BJT or bipolar junction transistor and FET or field effect transistor. So before we start, let's first define what is a transistor. A transistor is any semiconductor device that is used for switching and amplifications. So in this slide, we can see the real image or real life picture of a FET and a BJT. So focusing in the right side, BJT is bipolar junction transistor. So this transistor is bipolar. So ngano bipolar ang kaninga transistor? It is called bipolar since it is induced by two types of charge carriers. The flow of current from input base is induced by two types of charge carriers, which are the electrons and holes. So that's why it is called a bipolar transistor. From the left side, we have the FET or field effect transistor. Field effect transistor is also called as unipolar transistor since the flow of current, so the flow of current is induced by either electrons or holes. So dili magdungan ang duha ka electrons. So di magdungan ang duha ka charge carriers. Magdepende siya sa kung unsang type nga channel ang transistor. We have two types of channels. We have the P-type channel and the N-type channel. For P-type channel, the current flow is induced by the charge carrier electrons. While sa N-type channels, the flow of current is induced by the charge carrier holes. So that's their differences. By the way, there are two types of FET. And that is JFET or junction field effect transistor and MOSFET. So dili na to i-discuss since ang atong objective is to differentiate FET and BJT. So let's proceed. For schematic diagram, we can see their differences. So sa BJT, we have three terminals, namely the emitter, base, and collector. For FET, we have the source, gate, and drain. So for BJT, the emitter is heavily doped, the base is slightly doped, and the collector is moderately doped. So why is it? So the reason is that in emitter region, the charge carriers are injected from the base. So all the charge carriers are injected in the base, but the base is slightly doped. So most of the injected charge carriers will go to the collector. So that's why the emitter is called heavily doped, the base is lightly doped, and the collector is moderately doped. So their operations. For BJT, base emitter junction is forward bias and base collector junction is reverse bias. For BJT to work in the active region, its base emitter junction should be forward bias and base collector junction should be reverse bias. For FET, gate is reverse bias. So for FET to work in the active region, gate should be reverse bias. Next, BJT is a current controlled current device. So why is it called a current controlled current device? So since input base is being forward biased, so ang flow of current from the input from the input B, it will flow from will flow from the collector and will flow from the emitter. So, ang mo-flow nga current from the input, which is the base, mo-flow siya sa current, collector, I mean, mo-flow po siya sa emitter. So, ang proportion of current sa C og E is the same og proportion sa input current from the B base. So that's why it is called current controlled current device, since same ra ang proportion from the input base to the collector and emitter. FET. FET is a voltage controlled current device. So why is it a voltage controlled current device? After our FET transistor is being reverse bias, so na reverse bias na ning input gate terminal na to, reverse bias, if na reverse bias ang input gate terminal, mudako ang depletion region. Pag mudako ang depletion region, if magdugang taog voltage, if mag-increase tag voltage from the input gate terminal, mas mudako ang depletion region. If mudako ang depletion region, mas dako, mudako po ang space para sa channel. Mudako ang space para sa channel, mas daghan ang current na flow. So by that, ginakontrol, so by that, di control sa voltage from the input gate terminal ang flow sa current diri ang channel. So that's why it is called voltage controlled current device. BJT and FET have the same active region. Active region acts as an amplifier and also acts as a switch in the saturated and cathode region. So same as it. So for BJT, BJT's input impedance is very low at 1 kilo ohm, while output impedance is very high. So why is, so what's the reason for this? So balik na sa schematic diagram. So gamay daw ang input impedance sa BJT, niya dako ay ang output impedance. The reason is, after being forward bias, after being forward bias, ang mo-flow ra diri, ang mo-flow from input base is currents. So that's why gamay ang input impedance and ang output impedance is dako. Since dako man ang output impedance sa BJT, mas dako pud ang iyang gain. So for FET, FET's input impedance is very high at 1 million ohms and output impedance is low. So why is it? So after na reverse bias ang kaning region sa input gate terminal, since na reverse bias siya, if reverse bias siya, so there is no current flow here. Ang naara diri is the voltage reverse bias voltage. Since this is the region for voltage, there is no chance nga mo sulod ang current flow dere sa input terminal, input gate terminal. That's why dako ang input impedance dere sa input gate terminal, kay walay makasud nga current. So if walay makasud nga current dere, mas gamay dere ang output impedance. Kay since wala may maka, mas gamay ang output impedance. If gamay ang output impedance, gamay pud ang gain. So that's why mas dako ang gain sa BJT kaysa sa FET. Next. So matang gingon na BJT amplifier gain is very high and same as for FET, FET does not have a very high gain. So for BJT, BJT has a low switching speed. So why is it BJT has a low switching speed? So as I mentioned earlier, sa BJT, the flow of current is induced by two charge carriers, which are the electrons and the holes. Since magdungan man ang duha ka charge carriers, so there will be a bigger recovery time. So there will be a bigger time for switching off og on sa transistor. So by that, bigger time for switching on og off, so mas hinay ang switching speed sa BJT. Compared sa FET has a very fast switching speed. Okay? Since, di ba, isara ka, it's either holes or electrons, charge carriers, ang mo-induce sa current flow. So, since isara man, so ang recovery time is very slow. I mean, ang recovery time is big. The recovery time is very small. Na-confuse ka. Ang recovery time is very small. So, ang switching on and off is very fast. So, that's why FET has a very fast switching speed. Lastly, BJT consumes more power, thus temperature dependent, while FET consumes very low power and is more energy efficient. Since we all know that BJT is a current controlled current device, so the input base here has a flowing current. So if there's a flowing current in the input base terminal, then there's a high it consumes more power kid. Okay, grabe man ang flow of current dito sa input base terminal. So it consumes more power, thus kung mag-consume siya og more power, so mag-produce og heat ang transistor. If mag-produce og heat, then we can call that BJT is a temperature dependent. So for FET, since FET is a voltage controlled current device, so ang sa input gate terminal is ruled by voltages. So it consumes low power, and that's why it is more energy efficient. So let's proceed for circuit application. So for circuit application, for BJT can be an application for logic circuits. It is used as an amplifier, oscillator, and multi-vibrator. Also used as clipping circuit for wave shaping. Used as demodulator, modulator, in timer, and time-delayed circuits. And it is also used in electronic switch and or switching circuits. And for FET is used for low noise amplifier, buffer amplifier, cascode amplifier, analog switch, chopper, multiplexer, current limiter, and phase shift oscillators. Lastly is our parameters. So for BJT, its parameters are determining characteristics, transistor matching, AC performance, measured results, stabilizing voltage gain, early effect, and switching transistors. And for FET, we have pinch off voltage, turn on voltage, saturation, leakage current, or DSS, low frequency transconductance, drain source breakdown voltage, maximum drain source current, and maximum power dissipation. So that will be all. Thank you.